Welcome to the Osmosis Daily Report on the coronavirus pandemic. I'm Rishi Desai. I'm a pediatric infectious disease physician. I'm also a former CDC viral disease outbreak investigator, and I'm the chief medical officer at Osmosis. So as I like to do, starting out all these episodes, I want to talk about the Johns Hopkins data. So let's just look at that right away. So here we have a total of 242,000 cases plus, and we've got 5,850 deaths here in the U.S. That's more cases than the next two countries, Italy and Spain, combined. This is also obviously the most in the world, and it continues to rise quickly. So what I wanted to talk about today is pregnancy and whether COVID-19 goes from mother to baby. Specifically, there are some studies that have looked at this. This is one in The Lancet, and I wanted to go through these studies and see what the data says as of right now. So this one looked at a handful of women, a total of 9 women, that were confirmed COVID-19 positive. And I'm just going to point out a couple of things. They said that essentially all 9 of the babies had healthy Apgars. These are kind of the scores you give a baby right at birth. And that they checked amniotic fluid, cord blood, throat swabs in the baby, as well as breast milk samples from mother to see if there's any evidence of the virus in any of those locations. And in the ones tested, they did testing, full testing in 6 patients. None of those patients had virus found in any of those sites. So based on this study, it looks like the virus did not seem to go from mother to baby. Now there's another study that did something very similar. This one is looking at 10 neonates born to mothers with COVID-19. And again, they were swabbing. They did pharyngeal swabs in 9 of the 10 neonates, 1 to 9 days after birth, and found that all of them showed negative results. Again, so the first one was 9 moms, and they tested 6 of them. This one was 10 mothers, and they report testing 9 of the neonates in this way, and none of these neonates had the COVID-19 disease or evidence of SARS-CoV-2 virus. A third study did analysis of 38 pregnant women, again, COVID-19 positive, looked at their infants to see if the infants had any evidence of what they call maternal fetal transmission. Does it go from mom to baby? And what they found essentially was the same thing. I'm just highlighting it for you here. All of the specimens tested, including some cases placentas, so kind of one step further, looking at the organ that essentially is the bridge between mom and baby, were negative by RT-PCR for SARS-CoV-2. They say at this point in the pandemic, there's no evidence for SARS-CoV-2 actually going through the uterus or through the placenta from an infected mother to the baby. So all of that sounded really reassuring. And then I saw this letter. This is a letter that says they looked at neonates, again, born to mothers with COVID-19 disease or evidence of SARS-CoV-2, the virus. And they wanted to look at these moms. They looked at 33 neonates. And of them, 3 of them actually did have evidence of the virus. So let's go through this. And again, this is actually different than what the other 3 studies were finding. And what it tells us is that maybe there are some cases where you see transmission, but that rate seems quite low, at least based on the numbers. So let's do a little bit of a dive into this one. What they found is there are 3 patients. They talk about them as patient 1, 2, 3. You can see the table here. All were little boys. 2 were born term, so 40 weeks here and 40 weeks for the patient 2. The 3rd baby was born at 31 weeks, so slightly different scenario there. Much younger baby. And the babies did have some signs and symptoms of disease. So, you know, you can see, for example, the pneumonia line, all 3 were a yes. You can also see that this 3rd baby had signs of shortness of breath, respiratory distress. One thing to note is that this 3rd baby also had sepsis from a bacteria, Enterobacter. And so this obviously complicates the picture because you wonder, was all this distress and shortness of breath due to the sepsis, which is very likely to be the case, or was it from COVID-19 or both? And it's obviously impossible to say for sure, but this is one thing that complicates this particular 3rd case, is that the baby did have another infection happening at the same time. But what they found, which I can actually show you in a graph here, or a figure, is that they tested the babies in their nose and pharynx, so nasopharyngeal swab and anus, and they found that the babies were RT-PCR positive, 3 of them. All 3 babies showed RT-PCR positivity, and then it actually went negative. You can see that the 3 babies all recovered, so that's actually great news. All 3 babies did well in the long run, had stable vital signs. This third baby that had a pretty severe illness and was quite young did have some trouble and was intubated, but ultimately did well, and that's the key. So what I take away from this is that, yes, there is some evidence of SARS-CoV-2 transmission from mother to baby. In fact, that was their finding. These are actual images of the three babies' lungs. You can see two of them, they had chest x-rays and the CT, all of which show some what they call ground glass opacity. So you can see some evidence of disease in the lungs. And ultimately, this was their key finding. They said, although two recent studies, and they actually flagged the two studies I just showed you earlier, have shown that there were no clinical findings or investigations suggestive of COVID-19, what they do say is that their study shows that vertical maternal fetal transmission cannot be ruled out in the current cohort, meaning that in this group of 33 women, it seems like there was a good chance that at least three of the babies did receive COVID-19 from mom. And so there is some evidence that it's transmitting from mom to baby based on this very, very small sample of three kids that show that they may have gotten disease that way. So that's where we're at. So with that, I'll say thanks for tuning in today. Hit the red subscribe button and bell icon below to get more daily updates and visit our COVID-19 page, which is osmosis.org/COVID-19. Remember to do your part to raise the line and flatten the curve. Remember, we're all in this together. Thanks. Bye.